Hello, everybody. This is Yakes87, and welcome back, finally, to Life is Strange Before the Storm. Okay, so
Steph and Mikey are playing games on one of the tables.
I bet they are. So I loaded up the game, and I had to go back and make a couple of choices that I made at the end of the last episode, which, luckily, I edited the other day, so I remembered what choices those were. But we just made plans with Elliot over here to go laugh at some drama kids at the Tempest, which is this. The
Maybe
Tempest.
This play won't suck.
Maybe.
Maybe.
Don't know. Anti-drug poster.
How could I possibly make it through a day in this place without a little chemical assistance?
Drugs. They will mess you up. Okay. What is this?
Well, at least not for now.
Sci-fi movie poster, huh? See Warren or Brooke. Okay. Okay, okay. Ah. Hey, I'm at the picnic tables with Mikey. Thanks, on my way. Okay. Get DVD from Steph. Okay. Hello, Fountain.
The future needs excellence. The future's an asshole.
Jeremiah Blackwell. Oh, it's this bitch.
Carrie Price.
It's Chloe.
Oh, right. I'm just teasing. People have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography.
You don't say.
Between that and the Vortex Club, it's hard to keep people from putting me up on a pedestal or whatever. But you know all about that. What with Rachel Amber? Am I right?
Vortex Club.
You hang with the Vortex Club?
I mean, I'm technically not a member, but I am being courted.
I'm not sure
The club should be a collection of Blackwell elites, but instead, it's some anti-bullying, hand-holding kumbaya shit. Not when I'm a senior.
Wait.
What about Rachel?
Rachel posted a slamming selfie of you two having the time of your lives. Do tell.
We murdered a man.
It was a pretty normal night for us. A little music, a little dancing. We murdered a guy.
You are so funny. Oh, seriously, though. I didn't realize you and Rachel were such BFFs.
Mm-hmm. That's us.
We're really not.
So, what's she into? You know, what's her thing? Is it drugs? I'm not judging or anything. I figure if she's hanging out with you, she must be into some effed up shit. You know? I mean, look at your face.
Seriously, I don't know why you're talking to me about Rachel.
Oh, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
What's her angle?
So
I don't like
you're
her.
Jealous of Rachel Amber. That's what's happening right now. Gotcha.
Oh, God, I don't have time for this. I didn't even finish the chemistry assignment, and you're being you. Oh.
That's me. I'm gonna sabotage your homework.
I'm sorry, Victoria. I didn't mean to be rude. You know, I finished the assignment. Want some help?
You? Help me?
Of course. That last problem was hard, right? If I'm remembering correctly, the answer was fluorine, uranium, carbon, potassium, and, uranium again. Does that sound right?
Perfect. Hey, thanks, Carrie.
No problem.
If you didn't, get that, that's the chemical formula for fuck you. It's F-U-C-K and then you. That's hilarious. Okay, so they're supposed to be meeting somebody at one of these picnic tables. Is this my people right here? Are you my people? Oh, I can't go that way. Are you my people?
I need my DVD from Steph. I bet she's nerding it up with Mikey somewhere.
Hey, how's it going?
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloody, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge? It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
Try me.
Give me a break, nerds. I've heard of tabletop games.
Cool. Now that is a creature I wouldn't want to fight.
Got my DVD? One Blade Runner, director's cut, coming right up.
All right.
Sweet.
$5, right? Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Rachel Amber? You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just, like, a friend thing?
What's it to you?
What do you want to know?
Steph has a crush.
Chloe, you should join our game.
Yeah, I don't have 50 hours right now. Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else have you got to do before class?
Sure. I like games.
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Oh boy. I'm totally an elf barbarian.
Nice. I could totally see myself as an elf barbarian.
I know. I'm good. Alright, let's get started. You are both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land. Now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders.
Now this is my shit.
Well, alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you and greet you. I am Elamon, wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernus.
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named,
Calamastia.
Calamastia.
Super into it.
Not bad.
The two heroes.
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
I once made a man kebab.
I once stabbed a guy in the chest with a sword, and it went all the way through and killed the guy behind him, too. True story.
You stand at a three-way crossing. To your left, the raiders.
I love Dungeons and Dragons.
To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the Durr dude.
Elamon frowns. The raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Your choice, newbie. Where do you wish to go?
Let us go. Let's go
guess
to the prison
it's time
camp.
Time to free some peeps. Let's go to the prison camp.
You behold a field of standing iron cages, each imprisoning a human villager, calling out for you to free them. Only a small, elderly dragonkin is keeping watch. He notices you, and in terror, runs into one of the few empty cages and locks himself in.
Ah, poor little guy. What's a dragonkin?
Dragonkin are like little dragon people. They're assholes. I bet he has all the keys.
Oh, okay. Hey, shitface! Get out of there!
The dragonkin hops up and down, shaking his ring of keys at you. He shouts in strange
language. Hey, shitface, get out of there.
Whatever he's saying probably isn't flattering.
Got any useful spells in that robe of yours?
Nothing that wouldn't blow up the cage and everything in it.
Let us, tempt with bread?
Apparently, I have bread. I try to tempt the little bastard out with it.
He sticks out his tongue, finding your offering disgusting.
Ugh.
Pick the lock.
It says here I can pick locks. Can I do that?
Sure. You spend a long time trying to pick the lock, but don't accomplish anything. The dragonkin makes an obscene gesture at what you can only assume are his genitals.
Oh, it's shit. On now.
LOL.
Intimidate.
Did he just say LOL?
Can I do that? Okay. I want the little bastard to shit his pants.
You can try. What do you say?
Listen up, you little lizard.
Unfortunately, he doesn't speak common, which means he can't...
I cast communication on the dragonkin.
Shit. Really?
Now he can understand every word you say.
Time to work some real magic.
All
so
right.
This is called a skill challenge, where you try to use...
Oh, I Let's know see. What this is. I grab the bars of the cage and lean in, nice and close.
He steps back, his scaly skin quivering in fear. What do you say?
Meat puppet.
I wiggle my hand. Hey, Dragon King guy. Want to become my meat puppet? How it works is I shove my arm up your ass into your head, and then I can control your mouth from the inside to say things.
He doesn't seem to like that idea.
Neither do I.
The dragon can plead with you. Please don't harm you, tall one.
Oh,
but I cannot
God.
Give you key. Durgaron, much taller and meaner than you.
I could make you
You're
shorter.
Short, I say. But you can always get shorter. Give me the key, or I'll chop off your legs and beat you to death with them.
The dragonkin cowers before you, looking left and right. He opens his jaws, and you think he's about to yell for help.
I interrupt his yell by shoving my axe into the cage, pinning his head to the bars without hurting him. Then I say the following.
This is going to be good.
Here's what's up. I'm going to carve the skin from your bones. Then I'm going to turn your skin into a little leather handbag that I'll shove your skinless body into.
So I get the feeling Chloe doesn't play Dungeons and Dragons very
that
often.
That way, the next time some asshat refuses to give me a key I want, I can pull your body out and show them what happens. How does that sound?
Wow.
That was
nuts. I'm going to give you a plus 10 bonus to charisma. Go ahead and roll. A small pool of urine collects under the elderly dragonkin as, hands trembling, it hands you the keys. Then it dies of fear.
Awesome.
Yeah!
Go team! Why don't you start unlocking the prisoners?
I'm on it.
As you free them, the prisoners run away from you in fear. What's next?
Let's go get loot.
Loot sounds good.
I like loot.
Let's go to the training ground.
Sweet.
Upon arriving at the training ground, you are spotted by a heavy-set orc who immediately shouts and points. There are a dozen raiders on the training field, all of whom raise their weapons and charge.
Okay. So what do we do?
I cast Urgul's Acid Blast.
Overkill?
Bam!
You conjure up a wave of acid that washes over the charging orcs. Every raider suddenly starts screaming and writhing in pain. There's a sweet and sour kind of smell as the flesh melts off their bones like warm candle wax.
Holy shit.
You see why I haven't really needed a partner?
The heavy-set orc sergeant still remains. He runs at you, swinging a massive warhammer.
All yours.
Pommel strike.
I do a pommel strike. I strike his pommel hard. What did I say?
A pommel is the end of a sword handle. Pommel strike is where you hit the guy with it.
Ah, damn it. Okay, I do that.
Except you're not wielding a sword, you're wielding an axe.
This sucks.
It's all right. Try using your...
You've delayed too long. The orc swings his warhammer at your head. Barely missing. Your move.
Fatal cleave.
Okay. Let's end this. Fatal cleave.
You swing your great axe downward with both hands. The orc blinks, then splits open like a hot dog bun. Fuck yeah! I'm awesome at this game! It's going well.
What about the loot?
Well, as the training ground is now a roiling pit of acid, it's unlikely any loot survived.
Dang.
We all make mistakes.
Don't worry, Elamon guy. We all make mistakes.
Elamon... Palamastia, the elf barbarian, is most wise and forgiving.
What's next? It's tent time.
Tent time,
you
yeah.
You enter the tent to find Durzeron, warlord of the raiders of the Black Well, sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur, swathed in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows. Wah, ha, 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 ha. Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
What an asshole.
I got this. I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
This is fun.
Fire fizzles this is out great. Of contact. Durgeron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit. All of my battle spells are fire based.
What about the acid thing?
Except for, you know, acid blast, which someone used unnecessarily to show off for Chloe. Palamastia? What'll it be?
Let's do a brutal punch.
I want to punch that stupid man cow in the dick.
Like, right in the dick?
Right in the dick.
You miss. Durgeron burst out laughing as you stumble past him.
Asshole.
He gores you in the side with a horn. 8 damage.
Ouch.
What do you do next?
Annihilation strike.
Oh, holy shit. Annihilation strike. That sounds boss as fuck.
1?
That's bad, right?
Not for me. As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clingy jumble of metal.
Oh no, a critical
your axe
failure.
Swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Oh no, 3.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg. Legs, plural, severing both feet at the ankles.
I am so sorry.
Durgeron moves toward the crippled Elmon.
Oh, shit!
I told you this was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgeron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp, stomp, stomp.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What should I do?
Jump in front of Elmon.
Jump in front of Elamon.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe. I mean, thanks, Palamastia.
Okay. Durgeron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
Uh-oh.
Shit!
Oh, no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgeron laughs as he impales you on his blade.
Oh no!
Lifting you high into the air.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey, I chopped your feet off. We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgeron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell. What do you do?
Swing for his arm.
I bring my axe down onto his arm. The one with the fire bracer thingy.
Oh, brilliant.
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
20!
20!
Fuck yeah!
Yeah!
You bring your axe down in a wicked shot, severing his arm completely. His bracer of fire immunity clings to the ground.
I cast Gignomi's Fire Strike of Flame!
Ooh, snap!
Lying on the ground, you conjure a flaming spear, which flies from your hands to spear Durgeron in the chest, incinerating him completely from the inside out.
Damn, Elamon.
Durgron is defeated, but your wounds were too great. I'm afraid Calamastia is dead.
I actually feel sad right now.
Better to have died a hero than live as a coward.
That was fun.
Check out what I drew.
Mikey's got serious drawing skills.
That's awesome.
Glad you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah, I'll adventure with you anytime.
We'll see. Thanks for the game, nerds.
Oh, that was awesome.
Check. Next stop, chemistry class. Joy.
Get to chemistry class. Alright. Time for chemistry class. So we're heading back into the school. Let's look.
I would sacrifice a goat to Jeremiah Blackwell himself if it meant I'd be leaving here in a month.
So the school is where the first Life is Strange took place. So I'm pretty excited to get to look at the school again.
What have you got here, Twitch? Don't call me that!
True North. A jock so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Oh, wow. This is some really weird crap, Prescott. It's not yours. Give it back! I hate that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
Guys, no need to fight. You can both be losers.
The mute speaks? Whoa! You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch.
Oh, God.
You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
At least my family pays tuition. How much financial aid does your deadbeat dad need again?
Wow. Dick move, Nathan.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard when your dad closed it down. And you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone.
Who's that?
You know something, Prescott? I'm gonna do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
You're a piece of shit. I am going to kill you.
You guys, stop. Chloe, do something. Don't just stand there watching.
What am I going to do? I'm going to step in.
The only way to stop a bully is to be aggressive. I've got to put Drew down.
Stop being a dick.
Back off,
even though
idiot.
Nathan Prescott is a dick.
What the hell did you just say to me?
Back off. As in, go away. No one's interested in your crap.
You're seriously defending Nathan Prescott?
How about picking on someone your own size? Which I hear is pretty small.
You're such a crazy freak. Mind your own business.
You know what's crazy?
What's crazy is that you haven't been held back yet. How is that possible?
You want a piece of this?
A piece of your bromance?
You mean your budding bromance with Nathan? You're clearly into him. Just pull his hair already.
Did you just laugh?
I did. Chloe just owned you.
Shut the fuck up, fresh meat.
You shut the fuck up.
Go, Samantha.
Guess you got lucky this time, Prescott. Had two girls show up to save you. Take your perfect look.
Are you okay?
You think I need help? From you?
You're welcome.
Are you alright? Thanks for sticking up for him. People think just because of his family.
Everything okay here?
Yeah.
No problem, Skip.
Okay. Alright. Glad we talked. Me too. I know you're doing your best. Love you. Thank you. Wildfire danger.
This makes being high sound like a bad thing.
yeah. So, I'm gonna go ahead and stop this one here. Didn't really progress too much on the story, but I had so much fun doing the little Dungeons and Dragons minigame. That was a blast, and I hope I can run into more, like, random things like that.
If I'm late to class, that's just one more excuse for Mom to sick David on me.
Thank you for interrupting me. But, I know, like, when I did Life is Strange, my priority was going to be getting through the story. But since this game itself is a lot shorter, I'm going to try to do more exploring. Now, like if this was the me doing my old Life is Strange series, I would have obviously skipped out on the whole Dungeons and Dragons, you know, minigame thing just to save time and get through the main story. But definitely going to take some time to explore this game.
Excuses to stay out here. Must mean it's chemistry time.
Yes, thank you for interrupting me again. But yeah, I'm going to just enjoy the game, explore the game, and see what cool things we can find. So, thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know what you think, and we'll see you in the next one. See you later.